Welcome, dear students and staff, and anyone else that joins in today. Welcome at this very special occasion of the opening of the academic year. Obviously, this year is very different from other years because we celebrate the opening of our academic year online. And it's really nice that you have dressed up so well for this formal occasion, and I warmly welcome you at this ceremony. Now, as you can see here in this auditorium, usually we have around 700 guests to attend the formal opening of the year. We have our professors and staff and students. And now we do it differently. But should this make us feel bad? Does this make us feel less attached and connected to the university and the campus, or to our students and colleagues? The opposite, I would say. On a national level, polls have shown that about 75% of the Dutch support our government in these corona times and expressed that they have felt more solidarity and unity than before. Our own survey amongst the staff showed, besides a high response, a lot of satisfaction of how the university community is working together in these difficult times. It has now been more than 7 months that each and every one of us have become affected by corona in our daily lives. Some of us have fallen ill, or have family and friends who became contaminated, or even lost a dear one. All of us are profoundly touched. It is also almost 6 months ago that our university has become a digital one. Only in a fortnight and continued to provide education. Our scientists, our staff, started to work from attics, basements, and kitchen tables, dividing their time between the university and children, dogs and cats, all vying for attention. Our students had to study hard, stuck to their screens, sometimes in difficult circumstances, such as a noisy room. Our foreign students were sometimes not able to see their loved ones and family for all of this period. I am very, very proud that given these difficult circumstances, we have succeeded to continue our services and to keep the university up and running. It has been a major effort. I have read several times the comparison that the Dutch fight corona like we fight the sea and the water in an ever heroic battle. I believe that in academia we are a little bit more modest. Just a little. We know that water and epidemics are not the only troubles and that there are so many other wicked problems facing us. But I am proud that all of us together have adapted so quickly. Let us compliment ourselves with a quote from Albert Einstein. The measure of intelligence is the ability to change. Nobody is able to predict how corona is going to develop and if it will be able to disrupt our lives for long. For now, we have proved that we are flexible and resilient. We have proved that we can stay connected. We have even turned the situation to the better. We became expert in holding efficient and short meetings. We know how to look each other up faster than before, through Skype, Zoom, Teams, and be it in Amsterdam, Beijing, or Cape Town. Students continue to find our university attractive, and more have registered than before. Our scientists contributed to deal with the crisis through their innovative research and creativity. From developing an app for young people to cope with stress and anxiety during corona, to programming 3D printers for intubation machines. We are, of course, a university which stimulates entrepreneurship.
Dear students, Mr. President of the Executive Board, Koen Bekking, and members of the Executive Board, Traditionally, at around this time of the year, we take time to reflect on the start of a new academic year. But this time around, things are different at what we are used to, because the whole world is very different at this time. Coronavirus means that many of the things that we used to take for granted are now impossible. Shaking hands when we meet someone, living and working closely together, these things are not possible at the moment. Social distancing is affecting every aspect of our society and requires adaptability, discipline, and creativity from all of us. And in all likelihood, this will continue to be the case for some time to come, because even though things have changed since the spring, the virus is still circulating. Naturally, this is also having an impact on life at our university. And it seems likely that this situation will continue throughout this academic year. Students and teaching staff will need to be flexible. The way we meet and share knowledge is completely different now, and this will often be done digitally. But it will help if we focus on things that are possible instead of thinking of things which are not possible. Ladies and gentlemen, dear students, the start of a new academic year is traditionally a time when new students get to know each other and the university, visit study associations, and head out to discover the city. As mayor of Tilburg, it's an honor to welcome you, our new students in our town. I hope that you will feel at home here very quickly, even though this year your introduction to the university and to life in Tilburg is different from what we are used to. It's disappointing, both for you and everyone involved in organizing introduction activities, that we need to do the things differently this year. But at least you will have the chance to get to know the DNA of Tilburg. No matter what challenges we face, we get on with things and we use our creativity, flexibility and energy to make things work. We are delighted to have you here. Students are important to the society of Tilburg and help make this city as vibrant and lively as it is today. Ladies and gentlemen, dear members of the executive board, we very much value the links between the city authorities and the university at all levels. In recent years, the partnership between the city of Tilburg and Tilburg University has become increasingly close. The fine collaboration can be largely contributed to the unwavering effort of Koen Becken, the president of the executive board. Koen, now you're leaving Tilburg University. I would like the opportunity to thank you, Koen, for all the hard work in making the partnership between the university and the city of Tilburg making a big success. I would like to take the opportunity to give my sincere thanks to Professor Klaas Seitzma, the Rector Magnificus since September 2019. I have no doubt that with the new Rector Magnificus, Dr. Wim van der Donk, the bonds between the university and the city of Tilburg will continue to be strong. A good understanding between the university and the city brings a lot of chances. We exchange knowledge, research, data and experiences. We build partnerships that are valuable to both our organization. And by doing this, we help the city, the region and maybe even the whole country to make progress. And especially at times like this, the value that we create is particularly clear. Academic research has a vital role to play in political decision making and governance, such as the best way to respond to the coronavirus outbreak. But there are many other examples too. Nitrogen pollution, investigating and solving crimes. Today's students will be tomorrow's corona specialists, doctors, lawyers, judges and decision makers. What will our world look like after the pandemic is over? Dear students, you can help us to answer that question. The future economists among us can look into the question of what measures we need to take to ensure that everyone can find a suitable job, or how we can continue to ensure that Tilburg stays attractive for business. And there are many other questions too. What effect does working from home have on people? How does democratic accountability relate to government measures to control the virus? Dear students, there's so much work to do. I hope that Tilburg can count on your support. And I wish you an enjoyable and successful academic year.
Serving and enhancing society to help citizens. That's what drives Tilburg University. We believe that those who want to understand society should be actively and consciously involved in it. Tilburg University also encourages entrepreneurship and entrepreneurial thinking, knowledge and research, because entrepreneurship empowers people to be creative and innovative and enables them to make a difference and contribute to society. Also during the corona crisis, young entrepreneurs show resilience. For example, Bas van der Werf, 24-year-old business economics student. He founded a legal help desk with documents and legal information for other entrepreneurs regarding corona.
I started my first company during my studies at Tilburg University, and in which I encountered some legal issues, but I couldn't find a good partner for me to help me because they were all too expensive. So I thought, all right, there are so many startups and freelancers that need this kind of help. I'll start it myself. At Lex, we mostly aim to make the companies that we help legally healthy in order to prevent mostly unwanted situations. We're making it possible to shop the contracts online, let them be customized to the companies by one of our lawyers. And in that way, it has never been easier nor cheaper to do so and to help those companies. Okay, so when COVID-19 hit us at Lex, we saw a massive drop in the B2B sector, so new clients became very scarce. But on the other hand, we really saw a switch into the questions we got. So for the matter of those questions, which were way more of, all right, how is my company doing with like risk assessment and risk averse? We developed a legal blueprint in which we could really see in which ways certain contracts could help those companies to overcome the COVID-19 crisis, or to really be a bit more stronger in the crisis. So after a few months of COVID-19, we can really see the markets picking up again. New clients started coming. But the legal blueprint we developed, it fits so good to all the companies that we decided to keep it. So if COVID is still here in a few months' time, we'll still be online because that's our core business. And of course, we'll just try to be moving with the market as it goes.
It was really weird beginning, especially because I was supposed to go to my parents just for a weekend, but it lasted 2 or 3 months that I spent with my parents.
The first few weeks were hard to adapt because as students you want to see each other, you want to go to the library, you want to study together, and that was all not possible anymore.
And I think for most students it's been a difficult time, especially because you miss the social interaction between your fellow students, your professors.
It had a big impact on the way you had to study, because normally I like to go to the library every day, like around the time you have exams. And this time you could not, and I have to arrange in my room a study place. And that was very hard to be motivated.
We do see some positive impacts, because we have seen that it's possible to have a lot of video lectures online, because the university had to switch. And we hope to see this more in the future, even when corona is over, because we think that it's good for the flexibility of the students. So we think the extracurricular activities are as important as the studies itself. So we hope to see more of that. With working groups, it was really nice that you could have contact with other students and with the professor. You could discuss things, and it was really nice to meet sometimes in person or via a Zoom call to discuss more about the topic. In the beginning, when I was at my parents' house, it was mostly following the lectures live as much as possible. And next to that, we had some group projects, so we just met online via Zoom.
With the university, it was a little bit harder because you had the online lectures. But I tried to watch them live because then it felt more like a connection. I don't know if that's right, but like it felt more like you should do that at that time.
And with my friends from university, we had some online activities such as an online pub quiz or ranking the stars with your friends. And next year, I hope to see a nice combination of online and offline events, and that as soon as possible, we can all be back at our beautiful campus.
But mostly for the first years, I hope that they can have a great time and see how beautiful and fun Tilburg is, as we do, because it's really fun. So I hope that they have a great time here and they can connect with other students and with the university as well.
In this project, we are interested in how we can raise the productivity level of small retailers in Jakarta, in the context of Indonesia, and understanding how business practices relate to their productivity growth.
What we do is to curate the local knowledge available. We develop a handbook of these best practices. We distributed the handbook around 1,000 retailers. And then we top up this handbook with a movie and with assistance. And we proved that this was really effective for these retailers and improved their profits by 35%.
Tineke Roelofs, psycholoog in een verpleeghuis, is met dit project naar voren gekomen omdat ze in het verpleeghuis zag dat er vooral aandacht voor probleemgedrag was en eigenlijk nauwelijks voor de gewone beleving van liefde, intimiteit en seksualiteit. Wat betreft wetenschappelijke output zijn er 5 wetenschappelijke publicaties in internationale journals gepubliceerd. Met het mbo-onderwijs hebben we ook een 3-delige workshop ontwikkeld. En daarnaast hebben we een inspiratiedag georganiseerd waarin verpleegkundigen en verzorgenden uit de verpleeghuizen zijn uitgenodigd om na te denken over hoe ze dit onderwerp de plek kunnen geven die het verdient in het verpleeghuis.
Mijn onderzoeksproject ging over rookvrije schoolterrein in het voortgezet onderwijs. Dit onderwerp heeft heel veel media-aandacht gekregen. Ben ik vaak geconsulteerd om advies te geven over hoe je zo'n rookbeleid nou kunt invoeren. En tot slot, en ik denk dat dat wel de hoogst haalbare maatschappelijke impact die een wetenschapper kan hebben. En dat is dat vanaf 1 augustus wetgeving van kracht is gegaan voor rookvrije schoolterreinen. En deze wetgeving is gebaseerd op de resultaten van mijn proefschrift.
The Impact Award 2020 is the first edition of this award initiated by the Impact Program. We thank all 19 researchers for the submitted projects and the impact they realize in society. Also, many thanks to our external jury of the award for the difficult task to select the 3 best projects. Andrea Evers of Leiden University and Bas van Bavel of Utrecht University were part of the jury. The 3 nominated projects all scored high on both scientific and societal impact. And the jury was very enthusiastic about the uniqueness of every single project. I am delighted to announce that the Tilburg University Impact Award is won by Andrea Rosemaas with her project on smoke-free zones in schools. In the end, this project reached the highest scores on all criteria. The project was very well executed, scientific research, and with a major societal impact. In terms of collaboration with other parties, the entire chain has been brought together. that is clever and quite unique and distinctive. Andrea Rosema succeeded to get a lot of media attention in order to disseminate her results. Finally, her scientific research resulted in an implementation guide for schools, and new laws were implemented by the government based on the research of Andrea. This project shows how important it is to connect scientific research with societal problems in order to advance society. Dear Andrea, many congratulations for winning the Tilburg University Impact Award 2020. Can you say a few words about what winning this prize means to you?
Well, thank you very much. For me as a scientist, it's a huge appreciation and it motivates me to continue this way of working. And I would like to use this opportunity to share my experiences about achieving impact. I believe three elements are important. And the first one is take time to stay updated with all relevant parties, so forces can be joined. And the second one is try to speak the same language. For example, for scientists, make results understandable, publish also in Dutch, and be concise. And the last one is work always together with parties on the basis of equality. At Transo, we believe co-creation is not a one-way communication from university to society, but concerns a cyclic and iterative process between science and practice. And finally, creating impact can't be achieved only by yourself. So I really would like to thank my team, co-promoter and promoters, but also all parties which I work with, who also put so much effort in smoke-free educational institutes.
Really nice, really nice. And can you say a few words about the next steps in your research?
Yeah, well, currently I'm a co-promoter of the project Smoke-Free Sport Clubs and involved in several projects concerning reducing problematic alcohol use. So I would like to use this grant for one of these projects which need it most.
Lovely. Well, congrats again, Andrea, and enjoy your prize. Thank you. Preparing for this speech, which will be my last after finalizing my second term in office, I came across themes of previous openings of the academic year: connecting to society, tradition and innovation, taking responsibility in a connected world, the digital society. I addressed our community, the connection with the city of Tilburg, the other Dutch universities, the Dutch government, the province of Brabant, and our partners abroad. All so relevant in this period, I would say. In addition, resilience was a theme we chose a few years ago as a spear point to support the society with our research. We could not have known how resilient we would become ourselves. Dear students, colleagues and staff, in the light of resilience, let me conclude with a quote I found from an infamous Japanese warrior who said, "My barn having burned down, I can now see the moon." I am aware that these are difficult times for everyone, and I am very grateful to you for your flexible dealing with the situation and for your dedication to your work, your studies, and our university. Given the worldwide self-isolation and closures, we have valued to be in contact, to stay connected, and to take care of each other more than ever. We have proven that we stand together in this crisis, and under these circumstances, that is the best outcome we could have dreamt. Thank you.
Dear Koen, congratulations, and I wish you the best of luck with your new function at Nyenrode.
On behalf of all startups in Brabant, I would like to thank you for your efforts in startup support, especially in Starterslift and Braventure.
Congratulations on your great new job, a new challenge after a long commitment to Tilburg University.
I would like to thank you for your cooperation, the conversations and sometimes the necessary discussions we had in the University Council.
In 2014, you received the Toffe Peer Award for your transparent governance from the students.
After having been working for you for almost 8 years, I really like to thank you, and I would like to say that they were absolutely correct.
We will continue your work at our university, also in the new iconic Knowledge Transfer Office.
In the past 8 years, we have been traveling together a lot. And always, even after a long night flight or a heavy lunch at the local restaurant, you have represented the university without much fuss in a friendly, charming way. Koen, it was a pleasure to work with you. Thank you.
Now a new period begins. I wish you all the best at Nyenrode University. Thanks.
I would like to thank you for always taking the voice of the student into consideration. As a student representative, it was a pleasure to work with you.
I look back with great joy on my time as a daily board member, and I would like to wish you the best of luck at your new job at Nyenrode University.
I wish you all the best in an entrepreneurial future.
And I wish you all the best in your new position.
Thank you for your trust in me, and I wish you a good time in your new job. Bye.
Thank you very much for watching, especially for our first year students, bachelors, masters, and for now, stay connected, stay healthy, and enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you.